It's a beautiful Wednesday late morning. I had to rinse off the porch. I don't know why, but all my boys, except for Mr. Grant in Magnum, want to pee on the stairs. The stairs over there too. I don't know why. And I'm like, you guys have to walk there. Why are you peeing on the stairs? Anyways, it's a beautiful day. It's going to be almost 80. So I'm going to pick up all the toys and Miggy's going to be so mad because I'm going to pick them all up and put them on top of the big brown tote here. Because I, as you can see, am going to mow the lawn. Yeah, got to mow the lawn. It's already getting tough back here where the grass grows faster. Must be a different kind of grass within the back that we planted when we... when we moved in, if you're a new viewer, there used to be a huge tree right here and we had to cut it down because it blocked where we wanted to put the fence. We had an old shed that was falling apart. The wood was rotting. Animals were living in it. Possums, squirrels. It was just a mess. So tore that down. So we had to plant grass seed back here and it grows much faster than the grass up here. So it's already getting tough trying to find the number twos in the grass out here, so we need to get it mowed. So what are you doing? No. You enjoying this beautiful day? Yeah, you enjoying this beautiful day? So after I pick up all these toys, I need to of course check for landmines out here, number twos, and then I need to go in and see if Grant's up. He's sleeping because I don't want to leave him in there, wake up, and then have to go pee and then pee on my floor. I didn't think about it and didn't put one of his little doggy diapers on him before he fell back to sleep for his late morning nap that he takes. Totally forgot about it. And Mr. Grant, he's 15, and he has problems being able to hold his pee. When he's got to go, he's got to go. And he thinks nothing of it, of going in the house now with his cognitive issues like doggy dementia. He'll just go. So I'm going to tell you guys, if you have a doggy, even that maybe a male dog that likes to mark, get some of those male doggy diapers. I can't believe how great they work. I was very leery. I kept thinking, oh, they're gonna leak. He's gonna hate it on. Now, some of you guys said that you tried it with your dogs and your dog wanted no part of them, tried to rip them off. I could see some dogs doing that. I know Magnum would probably hate it. I don't know if he'd rip it off, but Grant, he could care less. Grant's great. He could care less about wearing doggy coats, doggy sweaters. He was great when he had to have his one toe removed due to cancer. He was great about having to, me having to wrap that, bandage on his foot when he'd go outside so it wouldn't get wet. He had no problem, with that at all either. So, yeah, some may dogs not tolerate them, but I'm going to tell you what, it saved me a couple times with Mr. Grant. Keeping him from going potty in the house. My daughter and I went, okay, where did Miggy took the ball? It was just right here. Where'd you put the ball? My daughter and I went, where'd we go? Oh, we went out to Fenton, Michigan, did some shopping out there. She wanted to grab a couple things. She's on vacation right now for a week from her job. And we went out to Fenton and I let him out right before we left at 1 o'clock. We left at 1 o'clock right on the dot. Let him out. He went pee, did number twos, and got home. We were gone about 2 hour 45 minutes and he had peed in his diaper. He couldn't hold it less than 3 hours. So I was very thankful that I remembered to put that on before we left. Yes. Daddy was just calling, so I gotta get off my phone right now from videotaping because my husband's calling. So I'll check back in a little later. All right, water break time. As you can see, I went and got Grant. I'm out of breath. I started mowing a couple lines over here, and I thought as I was mowing, I better go get Grant because I'm gonna regret it. He didn't have his diaper on, and if he has an accident, I have no one to blame but myself. I can't blame him. So went and woke him up, coaxed him out of bed with a couple pieces of dog food. Yes. It's not really like being out here. He's ready to go in. No, Miggy. You got to leave your toys up there a little longer. All I've got to do, I did the whole back part up to the back of the fire pit. I did this whole side over here. So now I just have a little bit to do right here. And then I'll have to go get the weed whipper out of the shed in the side yard. Look at him. Miggy, you have to wait to play until I'm done. You don't want me to run over your toys, do you? And then you won't have any toys. Yeah, then you won't have any toys. Oh my goodness. Whew, I am sweating. Thank goodness there's a breeze today. There is a breeze. But that was a lot of work. That lawnmower isn't self-propelled, which I wish we had a self-propelled one. The wind is making the door pop open because the latch is broke. So I'm going to take a water break here. When I'm done mowing that side over there, I'll probably let Grant in, and then go get the weed whipper. It's a battery operated weed whipper. I love it. I can never start a gas powered weed whipper. So my husband got a battery operated one. And then I'll be done. Yeah. I found some buried landmines. That's why I call them landmines. They're number twos because, the first bumblebee. The first bumblebee, and you guys are trying to get it. The boys can't stand bumblebees. They always are trying to bite them, and I'm like, you guys will be sorry. You'll be sorry if you bite that bumblebee. It's the first one I've seen. So it was buried in the deep grass back there. Almost stepped on it. So I had to get the lawn mowed back there. And that's why I call them landmines, because sometimes you don't see them. And then kapow, you're standing on a mess. All right, guys, let me finish. Let me sit here, catch my breath, and finish up the lawn. And then Miggy, then you can have your toys back, Miggy. Well, I can't do any weed whipping because there's no line on the weed whipper, and I don't know how to do that. So I'll have to wait for my husband to get home to put some line on it. But this is the, just in case anybody's interested, it's by Ryobi. Okay, please be quiet. It's by Ryobi. This is the battery operated weed whipper I have, and I also have an extra battery. But we'll have to do that later on when he gets home. Okay, Miggy. Okay. Okay. Start throwing the toys back out in the yard. Kick his ball out there. And here's the stick. And here's the frisbee. And here's your goose, Magnum. You want your goose? You don't want it right now? No? And here's the little disc thing that Paul sent. There you go. Are you happy now, Miggy? Are you happy now? He was so upset those toys were up there. You happy now? I gotta go fetch my scooped its way back there. Put that up. I'm all done. I gotta put the lawnmower in the garage. I think I'm just gonna play with Mickey for a little while. and wait for my husband to get home. I think I'm gonna take a shower too. Yeah, I need a shower. Grant went back in the house. Yeah, just gonna enjoy the rest of the day. Maybe my husband will just weed whip for me. He can put the line on and just weed whip. Since he knew I was gonna mow today, and he didn't make sure everything, he made sure I had gas in the lawnmower. He filled it up all the way. But he didn't make sure I had line on, so maybe he should just weed whip later, right? I think so. I think that's fair. I think that's fair. So, yeah, I'm going to play with Miggy for a little while. Then I got to get in the shower. And then I need to go to the grocery store. You want me to throw that? You want me to throw it? No? You just sniffing some sniffs? You smell something? Yeah, so that's what I'm going to do. Enjoy a little bit of the day now that the major work is over. Play with the dogs. Take care of my poop scoop. And we'll call it a day. I hope everybody's having a great week, and we will talk to you guys again soon. Bye-bye.